Simon. Good afternoon. My name is Jim Conlan, and welcome to the latest episode of our entertainment show. As you know, each week we feature international major events from all different sporting genres taking place throughout the world. And this week we're delighted to preview something coming our way on Friday, October the 17th, in terms of one of the biggest sports entertainment events in the world. It's the Impact Wrestling Bound for Glory, its 20th anniversary, coming live on FITE TV network from Albany, New York. And one of the stars of Impact Wrestling and one of the stars of the Knockouts division in Impact Wrestling is here to join us this evening to talk about all about Bound for Glory and her hopes and aspirations in terms of what she hopes to achieve on this magical 20th anniversary of Impact Wrestling, the one and only Tasha Steelz. Tasha, as a former Knockouts World Champion and a 2-time Knockout Tag Team Champion, it's a pleasure to have you with us this evening. And how excited are you for Bound for Glory?
I'm very excited. Thank you so much. Bound for Glory is going to be October 7th, not 17th.
October 7th.
October 7th, yeah.
October
17th. The 17th, I think I have a date somewhere, you know. I have a date somewhere on the 17th, so I'm going to probably be chilling somewhere, maybe have a mimosa or two. But October 7th, yeah, that's where it goes down at that Bound for Glory in New York, old New York, New York. Yeah, I'm excited. Last year, I was in the Call Your Shot gauntlet. So this year, just to be a part of it in any type of way I can, I'm happy, I'm excited, and I'm grateful, and I'm excited to see the other matches as well, not just something that I would be in, other matches that's going to be taking place.
Yeah, and Tasha, it's a stacked card you mentioned there. Some of the matches, we have Josh Alexander versus Eddie Edwards. We have VXT, Chelsea Green and Diana Perrazzo against Taya Valkyrie and Rosemary. We have Mia Yim versus Mickey James. Mike Bailey versus Frankie Kazarian. Matt Taven and Mike Bennett versus the Motor Machine Guns. We'll also see Raven inducted into the Hall of Fame. And the Knockouts title is on the line with Jordan Grace versus Masha Sasanovich. But you mentioned the Call Your Shot gauntlet. You entered it last year. Is there a chance we could see a repeat entry again this year on the cards?
Well, you never know. I mean, so I have this problem, and the problem is Killer Kelly. Like, she's my problem right now, okay? I'm trying to get my get back, which is becoming the Knockouts World Champion again and being 2-time. But right now, Killer Kelly, she's just being that thorn on my side with her mind games and her trick playing. But little does she know, I love playing mind games. I love playing mind games with those that want to play with me. So right now, I need to handle Killer Kelly. I need to handle her in ways that nobody else has. That way she can get out of my way and I can go back to what I wanted to do in the original place since Slammiversary, and that's get my Knockouts World Championship back.
Obviously, is the goal the Knockouts champion? You're obviously a former Knockouts champion, and you believe that you can rise to the top of the ladder once again, I'm sure.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, technically, I didn't really lose at Slammiversary. It took like 4 women to beat me. I mean, and why wouldn't it? Because I am the brightest star in the sky, okay? I am the Boricua badass. I am the greatest that beat the greatest. It's just not going to take just one person to defeat me. It took 4 women to defeat me. So yeah, I'm ready to get back what technically I didn't really lose and then defend it from there.
And Tasha, how do you feel about the state of Impact Wrestling in terms of women's wrestling, in terms of the Knockout division? Do you feel that you are a par for any other division in terms of All Elite Wrestling, in terms of WWE, ROH? Do you feel that women's wrestling in Impact is probably one of the strongest out there at the moment?
I am 1,000% going to say that, not just because I'm a part of it, but Impact Knockouts division has been the strongest it's ever been, now more so. And I believe, just dare I say, and this is a hot take, that other women divisions are just following our footsteps. You know, we have just done so many different things that others haven't done before, and rewriting history along the way. And we have a lot of heavy hitters, and everybody gets an opportunity. Nobody just sits away. You don't see someone go away and then they all of a sudden reappear. Like, we have everybody, every single woman has a different role that they play in this knockout division. And every woman has an opportunity, whether it's tag team gold, whether it's singles gold. You just saw Mia Yim be in an X division match. So it's these things that just makes us different and stand out from all the rest of the women's division. And not to downplay All Elite Wrestling or WWE or Ring of Honor, because I've been in their locker rooms as well. I've been a part of Ring of Honor. So not to downplay them, but I just feel like our division is very strong, and our division definitely have a lot of different flavors added. And yeah, ladies, take some notes. This is how we do things.
And Tasha, does all that come from the leadership of Gail Kim, obviously a knockout sort of legend? She's the cohort in terms of women's wrestling. She sort of is the leader of the pack in terms of her vision. And do you all feel that her stewardship has got women's wrestling an impact where it wants to be under the leadership of Gail Kim? And how do you feel that your personal relationship with Gail Kim, do you feel it's blossoming under her tenureship?
Oh, absolutely. Gail being a leader of the Knockouts division, she was the very first Knockouts world champion. So she definitely set a tone in this company, and definitely wanted to make a change and change a standard and do a lot of things and give opportunities that wasn't given ever for women's wrestling. So definitely Gail, I think every division needs someone like a Gail Kim there. I think it would just be so much better. And she is just has an open mind to things. Like, she's just so open-minded to a lot of creativity, and she has like a lot of great ideas, and she's open to listening to us and hearing like our ideas and putting them together and just really just sitting back and watching like just everything blossom. And Gail is great. Love Gail. Love being under her leadership, because I can go to her about anything and I can talk to her about anything, and she understands, you know. And she's come a long way, and she's done so much. I think she's done it all, you know. She's done it all. So love learning under Gail, and you know, with her just being having an important role in Impact, all of us definitely enjoy having Gail Kim in our locker room.
And I know Bound for Glory has created so many memorable moments in the past for so many wrestlers, both male and female. And what magic moment do you feel that you want to create on October the 7th for your fans and for all the fans of Tasha Steelz out there in Albany, New York, and Bound for Glory?
Well, let's see. I can't go for the tag titles because that's already taken. Can't go for the Knockouts World Championship because that match is already taken. So there's just one match in particular that I can just get back on that path, and that's the Call Your Shot Gauntlet. So I would love to get in this match again. I was in it last year. Unfortunately, I didn't succeed, but this year, this is going to be different. So I would love to get in this match. I would love to be back on that path of the Knockouts World Championship, and I would love to take this title back and become a two-time Knockouts World Champion and hold on to it a lot longer than I did before.
And Tasha Steelz, in terms of FITE TV, how do you feel Impact Wrestling being showcased all around the world on FITE TV? Obviously, the big event going down Friday, October the 7th in Albany, New York. Is the relationship beginning to grow and continues to blossom between Impact Wrestling and FITE TV? And how proud of you to be part of the FITE TV network as well?
Oh, it's great. It's great to be part of FITE TV Network, because in case you miss these moments, you can go back and watch these moments, and you can watch them as many times as you want for as long as you want. And it's everywhere. It's not just in the United States, it's in Canada, it's in the UK, you know, it's all over overseas, and everyone can watch us. And I'm excited. Bound for Glory, October 7th, FITE TV. It's going to be on the Impact Plus app as well. So everybody tune in, watch us. And let's just see if I get in this call your shot gauntlet. Fingers crossed, because I really, really want my Knockouts World Championship back. And I will do anything to get it.
On that note, Tasha Steelz, an absolute pleasure talking to you today. We wish you all the best in terms of your goals and aspirations. As she mentioned, Tasha Steelz will be appearing in some feature in Bound for Glory Friday, October the 7th from Albany, New York on FITE TV Network. But for the moment, Tasha, stay safe, take care, God bless, and all the best to you and your own aspirations in terms of Bound for Glory. Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you as well.